And we are back. It's been a while. And last year I was quite busy, starting from the very start of the year, because I had some pressure from the university to progress in my studies. And when that passed, I was burnt out, so I decided to take it a bit more easier. And my headset basically took some damage, so it didn't really work for recording new stuff. But now I'm back, and I think I'll at least give a serious attempt at trying to record some more. And since I now have a brand new headset, I decided to test it out with Conan Exiles. And I might also continue with Natuk and possibly Demise. And Demise is probably going to get its third episode in the next few months, the Revenge of the Tavern Keeper, which was postponed by over a year from what was hinted at in the December of 2018. I think the harvest amount of 1.5 should be quite good. It's a very grindy game, so plus 50% resources is very good in the beginning, at least when you don't have good tools. And of course the taming multiplier is only half of normal with single player, because there's no downtime really, as opposed to playing on a multiplayer server where the thralls keep doing their stuff even when you're locked out. I don't really need these. Not sure if I want to touch purge rules right now. It did seem to be quite slow when I tested things out. Actually, I wish I knew what the barbaric difficulty setting defaults were, so that I could base my custom on those, but it doesn't really. If I click barbaric, I don't see these meters at all. And if I re-click custom after that, it just shows what I had in the custom, not what the barbaric is about, so that's unfortunate. But yeah, I had one recorded session of this game, but there were some technical issues, so I'm basically redoing the first start. I got to level 25 in that first recording session, so that's why I'm increasing the experience multiplier to 1.1 from 1.0 to make it easier to catch up with that lost progress. It should be a significant increase, because you get a lot of free experience basically from completing the various journey steps this game instructs you to do. And when you got all the easy journey steps done, you are around level 20 maybe. So after that it's down to slaying and crafting and stuff like that. And the other journey steps that will slowly become more and more completable. But this is the character generation choose a Nordheimer because I'm Scandinavian. For religion, we'll choose Set, the Serpent God. I'm using the learned voice. And I really don't know which one to pick. I'm going to do some alterations. That's not horribly ugly, even with my current details. I have partial nudity enabled, so actually it's none, because it's a server setting that I haven't touched. So we definitely shouldn't have any issues with that from YouTube's side. Inciting a riot, skullduggery and buggery, and bribing a watchman, so nothing really sinister, I don't think. And now we get the starter
during
story.
The year of the Cobra,
basically.
A prisoner captured by unknown means was transported into the exiled lands, crucified, and left to die for crimes that they may or may not have committed. Death comes swiftly on black wings, until fate intervenes.
Thirsty, dead man. Shall I cut you down from that corpse tree? It might kill you. You civilized men are soft. Your lives are not nailed to your spines. Where I come from, we kill our enemies in battle. We don't leave them in the desert to die like dogs. So, you live again, dead man.
That's an interesting glitch.
This land does not love men. The ghost fence wearing that. It might have been kinder to leave you on the cross. Live, love, burn with life, slay and survive. We will meet again, dead man.
Now I think it's actually loading the game proper. This might take a while. No, it was fast this time around. So, we see the journey steps on the upper right hand of the screen. Climb, drink and eat. There are more, but it only shows three at a time. So we'll start by getting some stones, reading this tablet.
Behold, bonded
which completes a
the very
journey step that wasn't shown.
Civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, by the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
Now there's a note.
I am beaten. Left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here. Slaves. Bandits and cannibals. Exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me. The sun over the glittering spires of Belverus has forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence, and this cursed land will finally end me. To whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water, and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
So, because you have a harvesting multiplier of 1.5, you can see that by picking up stones, I only get one. Because it does not seem to do anything with the decimals when they don't form a next integer. But occasionally we get, like now, three plant fibers. That's where the 1.5 actually gets to matter, because it would have normally been 2, but 2 times 1.5 is 3. So that's going to be a huge increase when we get actual tools, and even better tools after that. And we can eat the handful of insects, which is a journey step, and we can drink from the water skin. It's just 3 gulps left. We can also climb most of the surfaces in this game, at least outside of instances. We can also kick. Well, usually, but not always. Some weapons do something else with that button. And then we can clothe ourselves. Yeah, this is not a blind playthrough attempt of this game, because I have completed the main plot before around 1 to 2 years ago. Of course, the game has been more developed since, so there are some interesting locations these days that I haven't explored at all. Or very little. And at least 3 of them are dungeons, and quite possibly quite large dungeons at that. These are the wine cellar dungeon, the sunken island dungeon, maybe? Is that its name? And the abandoned mine slash scorpion den. Dungeon. These, at least, I've not really been to. Actually, there's that location with the worshippers of Sobek that I haven't really explored either because my damage wasn't enough back then. They had ridiculous amounts of hit points. So yeah, I now should have some branches to craft stuff. We'll make the hatchet and the pick at least. And then we don't have enough branches to make a torch. But this is big enough a branch that it should be harvestable with the hatchet, so we get more than one. Different tools provide different results in this game when you use them to harvest stuff. So you want to use hatchet on these branches to get the tool harvest bonus. I don't think the pickaxe will do anything when used to try to collect these. And of course, to get more stone, we're using the pickaxe. Be able to craft a torch and a bedroll, at least out of these starting technologies. And there's a timid giant bat here that's going to get spooked by our arrival. I don't think you can even kill it, even if you had a bow.
Gods curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
These branches don't seem to be hatchet friendly, but that one was. But yeah, let's make our way to the newbie zone. The river, basically. But we can also spend some attribute points. We'll put points to encumbrance at first because it increases our carrying capacity. Because stone and wood is going to weigh us down, and we don't want to be slowed down by our load. I probably also need something like 250 stone for some starting crafting, basically, to make a 1x2 house and a weapon. That's our first tree, and we'll use the pickaxe on it to get some bark, because that's a journey step. Then we just had to get actual wood. And we also do need wood for stuff, but let's learn some new tech. And we have zero points available, but when we craft a so-called dedicated weapon, we should get another journey step and possibly another level. Yeah. The stone daggers are probably the best starter weapon in this game because their heavy attack causes targets to bleed. And the bleed is quite insane at low levels. We can't get the bruiser yet, so I think we need to complete at least a sleigh journey step before we get there. Should be fairly easy. Actually, let's harvest some more wood. And we should be almost able to build that box. We need some more twine. In single player you always seem to start at the same location, but in multiplayer you can start at four different locations at the bottom, I think. Guy. I do want the finisher journey step. So I did a dodge at the end there. Actually, can I get the butchering knife technology? Cost zero, so it's basically just unlock it and you should get it. We do want a knife. In earlier versions of the game, it wasn't possible to get that stone knife technology, but if you were lucky you could loot stone knife from an NPC, and that's going to be a really good item for getting hide at the very beginning because it's very good at extracting hide from corpses. Otherwise you'd have to rely on your hatchet basically. Oh, So that's now sorted out. Let's put our petrol down for yet another journey step. Ambush the guy sitting here. Looks like a cook. Cooks have usually daggers, so we want to avoid bleeding attacks of our own. So yeah, there was supposed to be a third guy somewhere here. Ah, there he is. Or she. It's a fighter, so they sometimes do manage to break out of the clinch locking mechanic of the daggers.
It wasn't supposed to be like this.
So we took some actual damage. No, iron bars, that's nice. Very nice. Right, so let's put down our starter house for basically two journey steps. So we get the shelter achievement and create a home achievement by building this small hovel. Let's eat some more to get our hit points up and build a campfire. Also place down the box inside location, and we'll store some stuff inside for the journey step, but you don't really need to carry these around anymore. That should give us the filling meal, so we're leveling up nicely. Actually, why can you learn apprentice tamer when you need a carpenter's bench to basically even craft it? Oh well, I do have enough points to take these basic things. So, a bed. We need wood for it. Traps and bedrolls are basically the respawning location for when you happen to die. Bedrolls are broken when you use them to respawn, while beds stay indefinitely. And you can have an active bed and active bedroll going at the same time. So that's nice. Actually, what was required for a shield? Oh, we can craft one. So let's do it then. Blocking an attack is a achievement, so that's gonna give us some additional experience points.